Thank you. Thank you, everyone. A humble district attorney like myself is not used to such a ringing endorsement. Even one who cut Gotham's crime rate in half. Now, for too long, this city has burned with corruption and greed under Mayor Hill's authority. But I promise you, a vote for Harvey Dent is a vote to finally put your foot down. Mm-hmm. Together, we can stamp out the fire and save our great city. If only Mr. Wayne, my campaign's largest backer, could have heard that applause, he would... Well, there he is. Fashionable and fashionably late, as always. Say hi, Bruce.
Welcome to Wayne Manor, everyone. My apologies for the late arrival.
Oh, not to worry, Mr. Wayne. We've all made ourselves very comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Thank you again, everyone, for your unwavering support. Together, we will change Gotham. Mr. Wayne, thank you for opening your house to us. Now, I know this is the biggest mansion in Gotham, but I don't think you got lost on your way here.
Where were you? I know you prefer the brooding billionaire angle. So the sooner we make nice with the donors, the sooner everyone will leave you alone.
Relax, it was important.
Not more than this. I know you despise these things, and truth be told, I do too.
What, a chance to show off your teeth and talk about yourself to a room full of money?
Say it ain't so. It's called playing the game, Bruce. And tonight, if you hadn't noticed, I'm playing for City Hall. No one came here tonight to see me.
Some champagne.
They want to see the Bruce Wayne, am I right?
Yep, and I can see him just fine from here.
This shouldn't be painful. It's not a kidney stone. It's only a little FaceTime with potential donors. Your face, specifically, with a mouth that's saying, "Support Harvey Dent." We're the grease, they're the wheels. And they're rolling in enough cash and votes to help make Gotham a place for families again.
I'll do anything for Gotham. It's my home.
It's our home. This'll help you too, Bruce. Once I've turned this city around as mayor, you'll be a hero for funding my campaign. Now all I need is a decent slogan. I'm terrible at those. It always makes me sound like a used car salesman. Which, for the record, I have not been since before law school.
All right. How about, our hope is in Harvey?
Yeah.
Maybe you. It's not half bad.
Yeah.
I'm gonna use that.
I like that.
Bruce, I meant what I said. Together, you and me, we change Gotham. A city free from crime, where children can play in the streets again.
That's what I want too, Harvey, but you know how rough it is out there. We have to shake things up to make that happen.
Well, we can start with a few hands, Come on. Mr. Wayne, I'd like to introduce you to
Bob and Regina Zellerbach. Of course I know these two.
Hello, Bruce.
Regina here is the chairwoman of Wayne Enterprises, and her husband
voted for Mayor Hill last time. I'll admit it, Mr. Wayne. I don't know Mr. Dent from a pothole on Main Street, but I trust your family. If you believe in Dent, we believe in you. After all, whoever you support is a reflection on you.
And we trust someone like you to lead this city to greatness.
Well, I'm flattered, truly, but this night is about getting Harvey Dent elected so he can fix those potholes.
I'm too busy being Batman, sorry.
I speak for half the room when I say politicians are puppets.
Oh, come on now, Bob. I'm not a politician. I'm a crusader. No strings attached.
Old families like ours should flock together, you know. Like birds.
You're preaching, dear.
No, it's true. The Waynes and Zellerbachs are reminders of the golden age of Gotham.
This city's luster faded years ago, Mr. Dent. Look at Gotham now. Murder in the streets, corruption in City Hall, that Cape Bat Freak dealing out vigilante justice like it's the wild goddamn West.
Oh, Bobby, regarding golden age, seems you're getting cranky in yours. No. There's always hope.
Forgive me for being blunt, but one man can't save this city. And it's a dangerous mentality to think so.
Harvey Dent
is our best shot. Put him in a room with anyone for 15 minutes and that grin will win him over.
Mm-hmm.
He's gonna need more than that, son.
Oh, it hasn't been 15 minutes yet, Bob. We've still got time. Don't worry, though. I am not doing this alone. With Bruce's help, we're replacing the dangerously unsecure Arkham Asylum with a state-of-the-art mental health facility to help Gotham's most at-risk individuals. It will be dedicated to Thomas and Martha Wayne in the hopes that their fate will never be repeated.
After all your parents did for this city, to be killed in a botched robbery in some alleyway, it was terrible. Truly terrible.
A tragedy like that at such a young age must have been crippling.
If only that deranged man had gotten the right treatment, maybe... Well, I don't like to think about maybes. And I'm sure you don't either.
Well, thank you. I wish my parents could be here speaking with you too.
And thank you, Bruce, for investing in the health of this city's future.
You have our support, Mr. Dent. Go get him.
We're on our way. Not saying I doubted you, but that went better than expected.
It is a night of ringing endorsements.
Harvey Dent, Gotham's next mayor, and eager to know you.
Vicki Vale, not interested, and reporter for the Gotham Gazette.
This is a private fundraiser, Miss Vale. No reporters allowed.
Well, you don't mind if I stay and ask a few questions, do you, Mr. Wayne?
Well, you can ask me whatever you want at the press conference tomorrow.
Actually, I'm here for Mr. Wayne.
No, it's all right. You can stay.
Thanks.
Bruce?
This is quite the social event, Mr. Wayne.
Oh, come on now. So formal. Call me Bruce.
Well, Bruce, you've been going around pleasing everyone tonight.
But he's my damn home,
How
of
are
course.
You doing? You should enjoy your own party before all the champagne runs out.
Everyone loves the host. You're king for a day.
Yeah?
Just a day? I would have guessed Bruce Wayne has that feeling year-round.
Yeah, well, I take nights and weekends off.
Mr. Wayne, you've got something on your collar. Is that blood? Yeah. It looks like...
Oh, this? No, it's nothing. It just, cut myself shaving.
What, your butler didn't help you this time? Hey, kidding.
Do excuse me, Master Bruce, but, another guest has arrived.
I'm sure they'll find the bar.
You may want to greet this one personally, sir.
Uh-oh.
Carmine Falcone? Is the Dent campaign soliciting votes from Gotham's biggest crime family?
Falcone's never been convicted of anything except being a businessman who loves this city. Excuse us, Miss Vale.
Excuse me?
And what kind of business do you think he's in?
The one that controls enough votes to get me into City Hall. This is the necessary evil of politics, Bruce. It's in the service of a better Gotham, for all of us. Look, at least hear him out before you kick him out. Falcone requested to speak with you directly.
I don't like this, Harv, but I'm trusting you.
Thank you, Bruce. Seriously. You know I have to pull every string I can to get elected.
Yeah, well, just make sure this one doesn't hang you.
A word of warning, Bruce? Play nice.
You know, I've been in the market for a new house. Decent walk-up, sky-high ceilings, plenty of room for my cars. I think I'll take it.
Take what?
Though the decor offends my eyes. Man, all flash, no class.
My family built this house. It's not for sale.
Everything's for sale, Mr. Wayne. And everyone. Just need to find the right currency. Carmine Falcone.
That's true.
Thank you for welcoming me.
I'm always on sale. When it comes to bullshit. Oh, great. Everyone's looking.
You're a respectable man, I hear.
No. Fuck off.
Gentlemen,
you look unexpected.
Perhaps we'll all be more comfortable in the parlor. Follow me, if you will.
You should know, Mr. Falcone, my analysts say we're raising triple what Mayor Hill has...
What the hell?
You'll be fine out there, Harvey. I saw plenty of skirts to keep you busy for a few minutes.
Harvey stays with us.
A man's home is his castle. I respect that.
Like, everything's got blanked
out. Seen and not heard.
Whatever you...
What did I say? Mr. District Attorney here wants to make sure the rules are followed. But in my experience, there's the law, and there's doing what's right. You understand? And I'd rather see Harvey actually help this city instead of just saying he will.
Unlike most people I've met, Harvey actually has integrity. He's trying to make Gotham a better place.
So am I. So are you. Hey, we all carry this city on our broken backs. Might lighten the load if we do so together. I ain't here to chinwag about politics, Mr. Wayne. Gives me a digestion. I got enough of that as is. So, let's talk relationship. Chalk this for me. Be a pal. I can get Harvey the mayor's seat.
Fuck.
Or I can pull it out from under him. Whatever happened to being a gracious host? Okay, imagine. This is me. And these are all my friends in Gotham. The businesses, restaurants, clubs, docks, unions, politicians. If Harvey gets elected. That's why I came here tonight to your lovely home, hoping to make a new friend. One who can help Mr. Dent see the light, if need be.
Look, I'm only talking to you because Harvey asked, trusting a friend to know what's best for Gotham.
Now that's a predicament. You listen to me, kid. I know somewhere inside that tuxedo you understand this situation. Money gets money. The risks, the alliances, the hidden costs. Your father knew which hands to shake. And which to break.
Don't you dare talk about my father.
You're getting worked up over nothing. Hell, I knew him longer than you did. People don't say no to me. Not for long.
Master Bruce, your guests are leaving. I recommend seeing them out. You wouldn't want to be rude.
Heed your butler's advice, kid. Oh, and I'm no longer interested in buying the house. The owner's a prick. Huh. And he's gonna get what's coming to him.
No, you're not getting the house. Too bad. Batman, the Telltale series. Right. What?
It's me.
Oh, episode one. Realm of Shadows.
Another brutal week in Gotham, folks. A string of home invasions rippled through the city's already crime-infested East End. Apparently, the bandits are using stolen GCPD battering rams to force their way in, with breaking and entering incidents up 40% over last year. Remember to keep those front doors locked tonight. And we have breaking news tonight. Five criminals are in custody this evening after a break-in at City Hall. But thanks to the efforts of the Batman, the stolen items were returned.
Not all of them. Let's see what she was really after.
Allegations that Dent may have actually been involved in the break-in. Talk about dirty politics. Does Hill's campaign really think these accusations hold any water with the voters? Or will it be perceived?
My suit absorbed most of the damage from that gunshot. I've got to protect my back, even from the police.
And in other news, you're now on day three.
Holographic lenses? Voice modulation? Wayne Enterprises really outdid themselves with this version.
Owned by Ace Chemical. Still no word on what started the fire, but whatever's burning in there has resisted everything the fire department has thrown at it. They're recommending people avoid the area and seek immediate treatment if you happen to breathe in any of that tar black smoke.
And one mobster's murder caused quite a headache for commuters this morning. The body of Falcone family capo, Louis Pistachio.
Look at the table.
Was found hanging off the side of the 4th Street Bridge.
We have all this stuff.
Just before dawn.
The newest edition can program it to reveal trace elements in a confined space. Can deliver a jolt or knock out electricity in the area. And I suppose that Catwoman would have preferred the latter.
It's the Kai TV messing up the dialogue.
Spare grapple. Can't believe I let her take that. Well, the test run at the mayor's office was a success. I should see if I can refine the edge. Could be sharper.
Two more patients have gone missing from Arkham Asylum, bringing the total number of escapees from the half-prison, half-mental hospital to 15 this year. Only three have been gone.
Nearly fell off a building for this? So important.
Takes effect today, making it possible for landlords.
Encrypted.
Aww.
Wayne Manor has 7 bedrooms, 2 kitchens, a library, a gymnasium, a basketball court, and a movie theater. And yet I always find you here, in a dark, damp cave, in front of a computer.
I'll leave as soon as I finish. People with regular jobs can do their work anywhere, but for me, this is my office.
I agree. It isn't normal work. Even worse, the best outcome is that no one ever finds out you've done it.
Yeah, well, good deeds usually go unnoticed.
Though not unappreciated. Did you find out what that Catwoman tried to steal?
Well, in the process.
What are we looking at?
Let me try a different angle. This is a map of the East Side shoreline. But it could mean any number of things. Money, weapons, drugs, everything
graphics.
Flows through that port.
This is all
Maybe
Gotham.
It's where Mayor Hill picks up his dry cleaning.
Can't make sense of it yet. There's still plenty of files to decrypt.
And in the meantime, I saved you what I could.
Crime.
Think so.
Yeah, the same couldn't be said for the bar. I had to literally pry Mrs. Zeller back away. But you'll be pleased to hear everyone has left, including Mr. Falcone. Before the game switched from billiards to cutthroat. I'd recommend leaving the fistfights to your alter ego.
Yeah, thanks for the interruption.
Well, it wasn't for you, Bruce. I was worried I might drink all my good scotch.
For the record, your father despised men like Falcone, thought they ruined Gotham's stellar reputation.
Back when it still had one?
It can again, Bruce. Though people like this Catwoman aren't helping. Is she new to town?
Never seen her before. Hopefully she's just a tourist. I'll check the codex.
That's a little codex. Look up info on cat burglar.
Found her.
Cat burglar. Crimes burglary. Petty Larncy. New criminal on the scene, tied to several recent break-ins. She's effective and doesn't leave any clues behind. Currently, the GCPD has no leads. I wish I knew more about her. Alright.
Not much to find, apparently.
A few burglaries, break-ins. Seems to lay pretty low.
You could learn a thing or two from her. You can't step outside without it ending up in the news lately. As Bruce or Batman.
I stay out of sight when I need to.
Define need to.
Whenever Harvey calls. That guy's exhausting.
Well, after the press conference tomorrow, I'll mark your calendar as exhausted then. The media isn't good for anyone's health. I don't mean to beat a dead argument, but...
No one's gonna figure it out now. Trust me.
Miss Vale noticed your injuries, so did Mr. Dent. If they put it together with the incident at the mayor's office, it would undo all the long nights and close calls we've endured to get here. You're in the spotlight more than ever. You have to be careful.
I've had to cover for mysterious injuries before.
You've been lucky.
Or I'm just a really good liar.
A necessary evil in your line of work, I suppose. Though I hope you change careers someday. Old men worry, that's all. It's our gift and our curse. One more worry for the list.
I thought I saw Oz. It's been, what, 20 years? Last time I saw him, we were in grade school.
Indeed. You two were thick as thieves. Oswald, however, took that role more literally than you.
Dishonorable discharge, illegal boxing matches, arms dealing, prison stints?
That's a criminal grand slam, if I'm using the expression correctly.
Unfortunately, you are.
Oswald claimed he only wanted to catch up, but his behavior following his family's collapse is troubling. Why he's returning now, I haven't the faintest idea.
I think he just wants to reconnect. Criminal record or not, he's still an old friend.
A lot can change over the years.
Yeah, that's true.
If I remember correctly, Oswald was fond of the old firecrackers in the toilet trick. I worry what he's graduated to.
Even though you and young Master Cobblepot used to be close,
I'd advise you to be cautious. But I know you can't abandon a good mystery until it's solved.
I'll be careful, Alfred.
When you see what's become of his park, I think you will.
The one that got away.